Hey guys, it's Phil from smilinggardener.com, and today I want to show you what the soil food web is, and I like you so much that I drew it for you. Right there. So now you know what the soil food web is. Well, I guess I better actually talk about it because the video would be too short then. I'm going to put it on a bit of an angle here, otherwise you're going to see the reflection of my window. I think that'll be good like this. So if you're new to gardening, you may have come across this term soil food web and wondered what that meant. So it really refers to everything, all the organisms, all the life forms that live in and on the soil. And the reason we call it a web, this is what I really want to talk about today, is because it's to show how they're all interconnected. If you have a spider's web, if you cut, you know, one or two strands of that web, it might impact the whole web. And it's the same with this. All of these organisms are important, and they're really important for our gardens. So what I did is I drew the plants in the middle. It doesn't really matter. I just did that because that was the first thing I drew. And down here, I have some bacteria, which are tiny one-celled organisms that there, you know, there could be 30,000 different species of them in a gram of healthy soil. So they're very, very tiny. We have fungi, which are also very tiny, and protists, which are also small, like paramecium. There's all kinds of odds and ends protists. And then I drew animals up here. And this is the first soil food web drawing with a unicorn, and probably the last. So this is a real special day here, I think. So what's going on here is all of these things impact each other. Many of them eat plants, bacteria, fungi, protists, animals eat plants. Obviously, the unicorn is a herbivore, so it only eats plants, I'm pretty sure. Although in Harry Potter, there was kind of was that a unicorn that was eating a, I don't remember. But I think unicorns are herbivores. Then we have, you know, fungi and bacteria. The fungi will eat the bacteria. The protists will eat these other organisms. Animals, especially small animals like earthworms, the tiny animals like nematodes, they'll eat protists and fungi and bacteria. They all eat each other, but they also work together. You know, there are cooperative beneficial relationships that happen between many of these things: bacteria and plants, fungi and plants, protists and plants, animals and microbes. Microbes are friendly with everyone, and they also eat everyone. So it's a very interconnected web. And I think the video is long enough now, so I'm not going to get into too much more detail about why this is so important. But the reason ultimately is because all of these things, having a diverse soil food web is going to make for a better, healthier garden for us. And so that's why I do talk about it a lot on my website. So that's at smilinggardener.com. And you can go there and pick up 15 vital lessons for becoming a better organic gardener right on the homepage if you haven't already done that. And that is all for the soil food web. I hope you like my drawing. I worked really hard on it.